Funny stories from life Freddie Mercury and his environment. In some interview, they asked Freddie, "Do you sometimes catch yourself on involuntary plagiarism? What is it is like?" "Well, a melody occurred to your head, but then it turned out that it wasn't yours, but it you just remembered something you heard earlier." "Ah, got it. It happened a little differently. A melody occurred to me. It seems to me that someone had already written it, but when I understand that this so, only this someone, it's me." Once in the garden lounge, they invited a pest control company to prevention, just in case they treated in the house with anti-cockroach chemistry, and the inhabitants were offered to temporarily leave the rooms. Everyone parted. After some time, Freddie returned accompanied by Dave Clark. "Today we will be alone here," said Freddie. "The servants have not arrived yet because we roasted cockroaches. But with this word, Winston and Hutton appeared at the doorstep of the house at the same time, returning, as it turns out, a little earlier than the owner. Seeing them, Clark snapped, "Arrived early. At least two cockroaches survived." When another one jacuzzi appeared in the house of Freddy, he allowed the servants to use it, seeing how they looked enviously at the bathing master. And the moment when Hutton took advantage of this courtesy, Freestone came in and said that Jim had forgotten to throw out the old white wilted roses, and as punishment he poured it out in the bathtub. They say, "We will collect everything after," and for a loud Freestone took a picture of him. Hutton later described how they allegedly took a bath with Freddy with the rope petals brought by falling in love Freddy. The beautiful photo of Freddie in the bath with a young lady. This is assistance to the choreographer of the Royal Ballet, Emma Crinty, a person known for her dynamism, Daniel Tumen. She would have extended the Freddie, but it turned out differently. Susan Cashley, partner in the ballet scene, showed interest in him. Here Emma couldn't stand it and out of principle displaced Sue, sending her somewhere for a far-fetched reason. Supposedly she was not included in the statement, or something else. She herself showed maximum initiative and all the time spinning in front of Freddy. At the party after the shoot, she also didn't leave him. Taylor, who had known her before, digged back at Freddy, thinking that Emma would dynamite Danny him too, like Roger had once. But the charm of Freddy played a cruel joke with her, and she forgot about her dynamite, inaccessibility, and surrounded to passions to the fullest. The photo was taken by Clark with the permission of the Freddy and provided that it remains in his personal archive. Clark promised, but many years later he still couldn't resist. It painfully timed out to be a good photo, what we are now observing. The selection was completed by Alexei Shevtsov. Information took from the group in ВКонтакте of Anna Kovalik. Thank you for attention.